students, let's we see the third subdivision. Yash scored 40 marks in a test, getting 3 marks for each right answer and losing 1 mark for each wrong answer. Okay, so had 4 marks for each right answer and 2 marks for each wrong answer, he would have scored 50 marks. Then we have to find the total number of questions asked in the test. Okay, so let's we move for the solution. Since we have to find the number of questions asked in the test, the number of questions will be the number of right answers plus the number of wrong answers, right? So we do not know exactly the number of right answers and the number of wrong answers. So we have to assume, let the number of right answers given by Yash be x. Okay, then let the number of wrong answers given by Yash be y. Let me represent the given data in a tabular column. I am writing first condition, then the second condition. Here the positive marks, then the negative marks, then the total marks. So the total marks is given by positive marks minus negative marks. Clear? So positive marks is awarded for each right answer and negative marks is reduced for each wrong answer. Okay, so see the first condition they have given. See here, in the first condition, Yash has scored 40 marks, getting 3 marks for each right answer and losing 1 mark for each wrong answer. Okay, so the positive marks can be given as, since he has answered x number of right answers and 3 marks awarded for each right answer, so the positive marks can be represented as 3 into x. Okay, so he has answered x number of right answers, for each right answer the marks awarded is 3, so we are going to multiply the x with 3. Okay, so it is 3 into x, 3x. Clear? Then the negative marks, so negative marks means they are going to reduce the mark for each wrong answer. Okay, since he has answered y number of wrong answers and they are reducing 1 mark for each wrong answer, this can be filled as 1 into y, because if he has answered y number of wrong answers and they are reducing 1 mark for each wrong answer, then the negative marks is represented as 1 into y, so it is y. Clear? So it is here 3x, it is y. Okay, then the total marks, total marks is the positive marks he has scored, then the negative marks minus negative marks, so it is 3x minus y, 3x minus y. Clear? Then go for the second condition. He would have scored 50 marks, okay, if they have awarded 4 marks for each right answer and they have reduced 2 marks for each wrong answer. Okay, so the number of right answers is x, the marks awarded for right answer is 4, so it can be represented as 4 into x, so which is 4x. Clear? Then go for the negative marks. The number of wrong answers is y, they are reducing 2 marks for each wrong answer, so the negative marks in the second condition can be given as 2 into y, that is 2y. Okay, here the total marks is, we are going to subtract the negative marks from the positive marks. Okay, so it is 4x minus 2y. Clear? So it is the mark scored for right answers, then it is the mark reduced for each wrong answer. Then we are going to equate this expression with the given condition. So in the first condition, Yash is scored 40 marks. So 3x minus y is equal to 40. It is the first equation. Then the second expression, 4x minus 2y is equated to 50, because in the second condition he would have scored 50 marks, right? So it is 4x minus 2y gives 50. Mark it as number 2. Okay, now we are going to solve this equation 1 and 2 by using the substitution method. From equation number 1, it is 3x. When I take this 40 to left side, it becomes minus 40. Then when I bring this minus y to right side, it becomes plus y. So I am getting y is equal to 3x minus 40. Y is equal to 3x minus 40. Mark it as number 3. Then substituting, condition number 3 in 2. So it is 4x minus 2y, 4x minus 2 into y, y value is 3x minus 40 is equal to 50. 4x minus 2 into 3x minus 6x, then minus 2 into minus 40 gives plus 80 is equal to 50. Then 4x minus 6x, it is minus 2x is equal to 50 minus 80. So it is minus 2x is equal to 50 minus 80 gives minus 30. So x is equal to minus 30 divided by minus 2, cancelling this negative signs, then it is 15. 15 into 2 is 30. So the value of x is 15. Then substituting, x is equal to 15 in 1. So it is 3x minus y is equal to 40. 3 into 15 minus y is equal to 40. So 45 minus y is equal to 40. Taking this y to right side, it becomes plus y. Then bringing this 40 to LHS, it is minus 40. So the value of y is 45 minus 40 gives 5. Okay. Thus we have obtained the value of x to be 15 and the value of y to be 5. Now let's conclude the answer. They have asked the number of questions, total number of questions. Since the number of right answers is x and the number of wrong answers is y, the total number of questions is given by x plus y. So it is x value 15 plus y value 5. So 15 plus 5 gives 20. So the total number of questions asked in the test is 20. Clear?